Okay, now time to chat because this top four game is already starting between Johan and Reinhard. So let's have a look at how the game's ended. So the first one was Johan, King of Swiss, beating James in the Martell Wars Mirror, still undefeated Johan in this tournament. We already saw earlier Reinhard beating Matei, and then Hannes beating Radek, and the last game that we did not see was Viktor with Tyrell Lion beating Alex with Greyjoy Filthy. So we have two Martells, a Targaryen and a Tyrell in the top four. And I think we'll watch this one when it starts. Might be the quicker game, and we'll see what is left. So, yeah, Targaryen, Aloof and apart. We saw earlier had I think four characters on the board at one time with cost 6 or higher. It had the big dragon Regal, it had Barristan, the new one from For the Realm, it had Khal Drogo and Khal Drogo on the board, and lots of attachments to basically Voltron some characters. So that's really strong board presence in that deck. But of course Martell Wars with the host of the Bone Waves and the new stand from Windblown is very strong in board presence as well when it gets those cards in the used pile, those plots in the used pile. Of course it has the strength boost as well, so that could be an interesting matchup. And the other one, so this deck that we just saw, that I think is my favorite in this tournament from the ones I've seen, really interesting Martell Lion deck that doesn't play like the usual Martell decks or even like the Banner Lion, for instance, in Tyrell. It has some very interesting tricks. That against Tyrell Lion is quite quick, so there won't be this time to get the Lion's game against that, like it was against Radex Lenny Kraken, which is a slow deck that doesn't gain a lot of power. Tyrell Lion immediately puts pressure on the board and pushes challenges through sometimes with Renown as well, and we saw that Hannes isn't playing any resets, so it could be interesting. But in any case, let's have a look at this top four game. So on the bottom we have Reinhard, Schefcik with Targaryen, Aloof and apart. And at the top we have Johan, Törngren with Martell, the wars to come. Card setup looks like for Reinhard after the mulligan, which I'm guessing is not what he's looking for. Drogon and the Braided Warrior. The other side we have Khal. Ariane Martell with some economy. And let's see what happens here, because I'm sure Guard Down is an option here for Johan, who goes first. Yeah, probably to get that Guard Down in and mess up Reinhardt's at the gates, and Reinhardt needs it quite badly. I was going to say because he couldn't set up an economy, but no, going for the Rose Road. So Johan not doing the, well, either not doing the city tricks with Galtown, or maybe he has Galtown in hand. So at the gates becomes pretty much useless after you play Galtown, so you may as well open with it and grab something else. But that did give Reinhard the chance to get a great haul, and I'm sure there are some high cost characters, so now this and the agenda bonus suddenly turns into 8 gold here. And there is the Galtown. The Rand's name would have grabbed 2 gold, but I started cancelling that. Okay, nothing scary on the board for Johan quite yet. Something like a card draw here would be nice for Reinhardt. Daenerys. Attachment that doesn't seem to do much at the moment, but of course she has insight and she might draw a card here to put Reinhard close to his reserve. Currently that doesn't work because Daenerys is standing. And no tricks, so basically just a waste of a challenge. And 2 characters will be lost here. Now this is more interesting, I think, than the Bara Aloof deck, because Wars deck, there is room for resets, of course. And I'm thinking Duel is a war plot, and usually these Martell Wars decks are not playing anything high cost except for the armies, which Duel cannot target, so that could be played right now to kneel Drogon and kill Daenerys or vice versa. Surprised that Rihanna didn't escape the war though. Yeah, Duel immediately, and well, PD useful as well, but of course Galtown enables the city plotline, and Water Gardens is pretty big. not keeping it. Well, Daenerys knelt, Drogon killed. I wonder if there is a way to resurrect characters here. For Reinhardt, probably fire and blood is in the deck, I'm guessing, although maybe not. Big Drogon and the 8 cost Traeger, I think, as well in this deck. Doesn't work as well with those as it does with the hatchlings. Khal Drogo, another big one, and the other side we have the big army with Intimidate, which can mostly, especially for the remainder of the game when its strength gets higher, it can defend Khal Drogo and it can Intimidate as well when going first. Still that Tyrell not doing anything, just defending. Wonder if there is anything in hand here. Because usually she... yeah, there we are, she likes to escape the board. And now this guy. I think the key character in... the Martell decks that did well in the final friendly open event. I think we had 3 in the cut at that time, and this guy winning initiative, allowing Martell to go first with the Intimidate army, and sometimes also to get the plot phase gold and cancel resets. And this could be important for Johan here. And now we have for the realm the new plot as well, which basically. There is nothing special about it, it's just an 8 gold plot if the reduction is used. And close call on the other side, so I was wondering if there was a way to resurrect Drogon. Here we are. And now grabbing some more cards here as well. I guess some economy would be decent here after that political disaster. Not sure what the other plots are. There could be a city festival, city of spiders, stuff like that. There could be manning the city walls as well, which doesn't really care that much about the econ locations on the board. And another big one, this guy we didn't see in the last game, Dario Naharis. So, ally companion or mercenary, I'm guessing there is nothing here. How's the escort is the only target. Talker stops power gain, but there is no power gain here on the characters except for Knights of the Sun, I think it's called, the army that has it down. And no gold left for Reinhard for any threats of burn here. Not sure if there is much in the deck. Yeah, Reinhardt can't defend this because he needs one of the characters to stay standing after the intimidate. Happy to take the dupe for claim, or the bodyguard actually. And I'm guessing Dario is the one that gets intimidated here because he can grab that escort. And already there is a decent threat of the runs game, of course, with 4 plots in the used pile for Johan. Reinhardt happy to defend this, has insight on Daenerys as well. And what is the attachment to Tokar? This one not that important, there is no claim. The card will try. Just one claim, so not super urgent to stop this. I wonder if there is Ario Hotach or something like that. Probably not, because these decks do like to play the other version. The one that has ambush, basically free ambush in the second part of the game. And here comes Ricasso. I wonder why. Be trying to play the Prince's plan here. There he is. Costs one at the moment, and it's only round 3. But he is not going to successfully defend this, is he? There's one character that doesn't really work that well with going first. Getting rid of Drogon. And some useful hand knowledge as well for Johan. Carl is still the only character that is duped here. In case there is something like Mercullis, perhaps. I'm guessing with all these high costers and this particular agenda, Reinhardt is not going to be playing any resets. Yeah, playing it anyway. Okay, so that gets rid of that Cercletus, which basically wins initiative every round. And what will heads hit here? Viserys, a cheap one that I'm sure could have been marshaled. And that's already 10 power here for Johan. He will have 6 gold without playing something like Indoran's Name or Water Gardens. Yeah, investment for the rest of the game. Just as well, if Reinhard does start to turn it around now, he will of course be giving all the cards away. There is no claim, so maybe just take dominance instead of going for a challenge. I think he'll be happy to see Arya Hotak dead, Cletus dead as well, and Ricasso. But Rian still alive. Nothing in the discard pile for manning the city walls. Actually, that only works with the hand. I was thinking of white swords. Second heads. Doesn't hit this time. And there's Summer Seaport gone. I bet Reinhard would love to see Dorne discarded instead. Okay, now a big dragon. With a bit of stand as well. And also winning initiative here. So is this about to turn around? Because Johan not marshalling anything, I wonder if I'm guessing he's not out of characters, it's just that nothing survives after Khal Drogo is done with his militaries. Question is, of course, is there any ambush that can come in later? And another one that is a pretty good hit here. Everything duped now. Even if there was Mergulis, there could be Doharis in the deck that would leave only one of these guys, presumably Khal Drogo, on the board. And with 5 gold left, if Johan has anything, of course it should be ambushed here. just something like a Shadow City Bastard would be quite useful. No. So in one round, back level at 9-9. There's the Manning. Which will probably be putting in one of the armies. But again, it's Reinhard who wins initiative. He has to claim, and currently Khal Drogo with his textbook box does allow two military challenges. On the other hand, Johan is one Durant's game away from winning the game himself. That's at the moment basically, but not if two claim power challenge goes through. Oh. Useful. No unique characters to put tokens on, but useful nonetheless. Putting this on his own character, that's slightly dangerous. Because you never know what can happen if the opponent plays Jaqen H'ghar, for instance, which I'm sure Johan is not going to do, or if he takes control of it, you can then use him to kill the character with the Valar Morghulis token. I did manage to do that once in a game, when my opponent was just messing around with these tokens, thinking it couldn't possibly make any difference. Yeah, so currently nothing will survive the military claim, and that would enable Reinhard to push the power through as well. So if there is any kind of Durant's game or anything like that, it will have to come from the hand, assuming the game is not lost by then. And of course, yeah, the six costers here give power away for price as well, so I'm sure if this is not the last round, the plot phase could be with something like the Harris played if Johan is on 13, but yeah, at the moment not looking that great for him. He needs something. And that's it. So crazy turnaround, basically in two rounds. Just a winning initiative, getting rid of that Cletus was the turning point, I think. And look at all of these cards in hand and nothing to do with them, because the two claim double military stops anything, basically. So Reinhard, first finalist of the Canadian Nationals, and Let's see if the other game is still running, and it is. Now this one not looking good for Hannes. I wonder if he can hold on here. So we have Knight of Flowers with Renown. All characters currently on 3 strength because of this plot. And Cypher here going first. So the first challenge could end the game. But still, Feuerbart to Martell in the marshalling phase, and there is going to be 8 gold on the Iron Bank. I wonder if Old Town is still standing, so that could just win the game immediately if Cypher knew what the top card was. So Cypher is Viktor Nelipovich here, and Hannes is Feuerbart. It's 1 gold on Begging Brother to cancel Septon. Septon could, in the challenge's phase, otherwise just put itself on the top and trigger with Old Town. Yeah, digging for stuff, because currently the game looks lost. So Annals hasn't been played in this game. Milk on the Scheming Septon, which can be cancelled, but not on the Knight of Flowers with Renown. There we go. Gaston Grey, well, it certainly is a lot of stuff on the board, so not that easy, but just trying his luck here. And missing. Well, it's going to hit in the standing phase, probably. If Viktor can stay on 14. And he probably can, because the runs game is not big enough this round. It's only a 5, so that would get Hannes to 12, so he also needs to grab a power challenge and to win dominance. So what now? Lacking some icons here. Only 2 power icons, but he did take one from the Knight of Flowers. And unfortunately, he cannot boost the strength of Aryo Hotach. Because of the Palace of Sorrows, but he does have 2 characters, so if power challenge is initiated, Aryo Hotach can go back to hand, increase the claim, and come in for free. And there's another icon as well. Okay, getting rid of the non-healer. So Viktor going first. And I don't think Hannes really needs to do anything. Yeah, I wouldn't have done this because the claim can now be raised. So instead of taking one power back, it will now take two power back. That puts Hannes potentially on 9 this round. So within range of that Drance game. But he does need to defend all the challenges. And this guy's free, so he can continue to raise the claim. Yeah, that's pretty crazy. I think the thing to do was just to pass here for Viktor and go for Old Town in the standing phase. Then see what happens next round. When all the plots are gone from the used pile. Link Boros. And now we'll probably see Ario coming back into play before this challenge goes through, unless Hannes plans to win. And he does plan to win, so maybe just trigger the Drance game on defense. And I think that's now game over. Because he can get a 3 claim power challenge through. Possibly slight misplay here for Viktor by allowing that claim raise, but yeah. We haven't watched the whole game here, of course, so we don't know if he knew Hare Hotach was in hand. And yeah, you're always a little bit unlucky if you go for Old Town name character. There is probably odds are slightly in your favor to hit, so that would have been 15 power and game over. Begging Brother, gold is gone, so still Hannes needs to be a little bit careful not to give away any renown on defense. And it doesn't matter what the claim is here, because it's an unopposed power, so it's 15. Anyway, so nice comeback here for Hannes. Yeah, surviving that Old Town trigger. Interesting to see Gaston Grey here as well, because we didn't see it in the previous game, and I didn't see it when I played against this deck, so that could be one to watch for against Reinhard with those high cost characters, of course. Okay, so let's see the final.